Wow, this is a great morning again. This is the money show game. This is a money game show, I beg your pardon. And you know, whichever way, it can either be the money game show or the money show game. I mean, the most important thing is that there is money in it. It's important. Yeah. This morning, we have come, me and my friend is with me in the studio. We are together as always. You know, this is Trudy. Trudy, how are you doing?
Hi, Daddy. Hi.
It's good to see you again, man. It's a wonderful day right here.
A beautiful one.
You know, wonderful day right here. And you know, this morning we are going to look at something that has changed our own lives, and we believe is going to change your life. And what is that thing? What happened to you when you are working in an organization and you are asked to go home unannounced? What does that mean? I'm trying to be polite. I mean, you are fired. You are fired and you are asked to go home unannounced. What happened to you? What kind of thing? A lot of people go through this process and they do not have the psychological backup to be able to sustain themselves and move to the next phase of life. So today, we're going to be sharing with you the kind of a Robin Hood strategy that you can use to move yourself to the next phase and be able to create an amazing life. Let me give you a practical story. There was a guy in Republic of South Africa that was working with a big shopping mall as one of the directors. And this guy was working there, and after a while, the boy came up one morning and asked this guy to leave the organization, and they sacked him.
Wow.
Now, and after about, this guy was able to take some of the kind of strategy you are listening to today, and he went ahead and started his own company at the same time. Mm-hmm. The same, you know, company. And in a couple of years, he was able to build another company that was at the same par with the same company. You may be wondering what kind of company is that. There's a company in South Africa called Checkers, and there's a company in South Africa called Pick and Pay. Now, a Pick and Pay is now one of the companies that is competing with Checkers. Checkers was formerly the boss of the founder of Pick and Pay. Now, that means you can turn your disadvantage into a redirection. Mm-hmm. And that's why we're here today, to be able to share with you and to take it. You know, in this, on our show, we don't pamper you. We're not here to motivate you. We're here to share things with you that will change your life. And that's why we're here today. So truly, what happened when someone is asked to go home?
It's a real dilemma for a lot of people.
Wow.
Because they don't have the required backup to be able to sustain their lives. A lot of people, like we've always said, a lot of people are, the reason why you need to work is not just for work. You should be able to, you are working because you want to achieve a particular purpose in mind.
That's right.
But a lot of people in the bid while they are working, they forget the reasons why they are working. They think that it is because of the employer that they are working. They think that it is because of maybe just to be able to meet ends meet. That's why they are working. But they forget the real purpose of work, but they go out to work. They forget the real purpose of work, and they are just setting out and just engaging in activity. They're just being busy on a daily basis and not and forgetting the real reason why that work should be producing results for them.
Wow.
So a lot of people are working just because maybe for weekends. That's why you find out that so because they are motivated. So when the weekend comes and you now face reality on Monday, you hate Mondays. But people are not, an employer is not paying the employee for weekend. He's paying him because he wants to get results from him.
Wow.
But most people also forget that I am here to make results. That is why they are unemployed. But one of the things that people should be able to do to get their lives out is that, are you working for survival?
Wow.
Or are you working for freedom?
Wow.
A lot of people forget that their freedom is much more important to their survival.
Wow.
So most people just work on a daily basis. They work on weekends, they work for the shopping mall, they work for ShopRite, they work for Just Right, they work for whatever rights. But they are not actually right in their own economy.
Wow.
They are not focusing on the things that will produce them results. So that when you are being fired from wherever you are right now, what will happen to your economy? A lot of people's economy is bastardized afterwards because of the fact that you know they ask them to leave the economy, to ask them to leave their workplace, because they are forgetting the essence of the job that they have right now.
Well, that's amazing, Trudy. I mean, I like the fact that you are talking about something that is very deep.
Yeah.
It says that a lot of people work for different organizations without organizing their own life.
Yes.
A lot of people focus on going for the pay,
yeah,
without focusing on what we pay them ultimately.
Yes.
So people look at their life, they go, you said the word, people go to work to for survival, not for freedom.
Yes.
That means you don't go to work for survival, you go to work for your own freedom.
Yes.
You don't go to work just to pay your rent, you go to work to be, so I can be financially free.
Yes.
You know, on social media yesterday, being Friday, and I said, don't look forward to Friday, look forward to your financial freedom day.
Yeah.
A lot of people look forward to Fridays, you know, and that is why you find out a lot of people say, thank God it is Friday.
This is the biggest hashtag in Nigeria.
That is it. You know why? That is a statement of a very broken guy.
Yeah.
That is a statement of a highly dissatisfied human being.
Yeah.
That is a statement. Now, this is what I say. If you have 7 days in a week, and the only days you are happy, as it were, it's Saturday and Friday night, because Sunday you are already in a Monday blues. Now, come to think about it, if you are a student and then you are having 2 out of 7 for all the semester in school, are you going to pass?
No.
So a lot of people are already failing in life.
Yes.
Every single day.
You get the rest of the days, but you don't just love the 2 days.
So you're already failing in life, because look at the mathematics. It's simple. 2 out of 7 for the whole semester. 2 out of 7 for the whole year. 2 out of 7. And that is how you live 2 out of 7 for 30 years.
Wow.
And then you are wondering, after you have lived 2 out of 7 for 15 years, a boss now discovered that you are not even engaging, producing anything, and then they ask you to go home. Now, Julie, I want to say some very fantastic things about why people get hired. I think people need to know why they get hired. Do your boss, the boss hire people because they love them or because of what?
First of all, if I'm going to hire anybody, I want to hire the person for 2 things.
So,
one is hunger.
Mm.
Secondly, is what their disability to get realize that it needs to get sales for me.
Mm.
Selling is the major reason why I will employ anybody. Whether it's an accountant, it's an administrator, it's a human resource individual, and all of that. Because every job that anybody does is useless if it does not produce income.
Consider it.
So if I'm even a general counsel or so, maybe in the office. But I'm not thinking in terms of generating sales, and you are not ambitious. Those are the 2 criteria for which you go to work with me. And I also think that most people who are employers also think alike this way.
Mm.
Why? Because they are looking for 2 solutions. They have certain problems, that is why. And the major problem in life are in sales. Because you know what? Every other thing, just like we discussed before the program, a lot of stuff can be outsourced. You can outsource administration, you can outsource human resource, you can outsource finance, you can outsource accounting, you can outsource even your legal, your stuff in the office. But one of the major things that you need to focus on regularly is what? Is the sales.
Mm.
So even if I am working as an individual, I need to be able to ensure that I'm producing sales on a regular basis. Why? Because sales is not what will get me fired.
Mm.
I have some people who maybe regularly they bring in sales on a regular basis. When they bring in sales, I don't care what time they turn up in the office.
Mm.
I care about the result that they bring into the office. I don't care whether they're coming by 8 or 9 or 10, 11. But I care about the result that they're producing.
Mm.
If they come by 10, 9 and 8 or so, and they come around that time, and they come after that time, and they come with a check, on a regular basis, I will applaud them. I will give them a thumbs up. Why? Because that is what I need to keep the company going.
Absolutely.
I don't need all those useless processes to keep the company going. So most people are not figuring that part out right. That is why they are not generating income. So if I find out that certain people want to work in an organization, what do they do? If they ask them, what do you want to do? I want to work as a banker. What do you want to do? I want to work as in the accounting department.
Wow.
What do you want to do? I want to work as whatever, but I don't want to, I hate sales job.
Mm-hmm.
I don't want to work in the sales department. I don't want to work in the revenue department.
Wow.
I don't want to think of how this company can generate revenue. But the truth of the matter is that what pays every other bill is sales.
Wow.
It's sales.
What pays every other bill is sales. So, Joe, if sales pays every other bill, why is that people always afraid? You know, one of the things I found, that, like you said, it is the hardest truth.
Yeah.
People want to work in organizations. People will say, you know, I don't want a sales job.
Yeah.
And then you ask them, what exactly do you want if you don't want a sales job?
Yeah.
Because the truth is, what is going to pay you is what you don't want.
Yeah.
And because you see, we are being deceived that going to school is going to make you rich. We have been deceived that getting the certificate, so you see someone, he has finished the first certificate, he will go for the second certificate, he will go for the third certificate. Now this is the point. A lot of employees don't think like a business owner.
Yeah.
They don't think like a business owner. Now this is the question I have. What are the three things that a business owner is thinking about? Because you see, if you are sacked today, if you are hired, if you are asked to go home today, if you can think like a business owner, if you don't start making your own money, company will be hungry to hire you.
Yes.
The first thing a business owner is thinking about is customers.
Yeah.
That's the truth.
Yeah.
A business owner is thinking about the customer.
Yeah.
So the second thing a business owner is thinking about is the revenue. The third thing a business owner is thinking about is profit. Now, these are the
revenue and profit.
These are the only three things, because these are the things that determine the growth of a company.
Yes.
You see, the size of a company is not determined by the number of people you hire.
Yeah.
It's determined by the number of the large number of cash flow that he has. You see, you can have 1,000 people and I only have 5 people working with me, and I'm making 10 billion in a year, and you're making 100,000, 100 million in a year. You see, I can do more good in the society than you.
Yeah.
Because you know why? The new big is not the size of the employee. The new big is the size of the profit.
Yeah.
That is the new big. In 21st century, the new big. So an employer is thinking about customer every single day. It's thinking about revenue every single day. It's thinking about profit every single day. It's not thinking about paying salary. It's not thinking. Now, he hires you for that three thing. Any of your role must fill that three thing for your employer. I don't care your role. Either you're an accountant, you are administrative. Ask yourself, am I increasing the profit of my organization? Am I increasing the revenue of this organization? How am I bringing profit in? How am I bringing customer in? You see, if you can't fill that role, go home.
And be broke.
And be broke. That is why you are broke, because you know why? You have never thought like an employer. You're wondering, why is an organization going to fire people? The truth of the matter is, nobody likes his brother, his relative to be fired. But the question is, do you have to be paid? And if the money is not there to be paid, these three things mentioned is how people get paid.
Yeah.
So when your employer, when you get a job tomorrow morning, don't go to church to advertise. Think about these three things first.
Yes, yes.
Am I going to increase customer for this organization?
Revenue generation.
Am I going to generate revenue for this organization? Am I going to increase profit for this organization? If you can't do that, you don't need a job. Go and be a beggar. You see, it's more better for you. Be a beggar on the street and just beg people, put on a tie. Give me money, because no organization needs you without these three things.
Yeah.
That is why you are asked to go home. If you